Oh, good morning, everybody. Oh my God, it's so bright. I can't even look. Good morning, everybody. How you doing? Look at me with the consistent videos. Today, I'm going to talk about something very, very important. I'm going to talk about something that I think so many people need to hear and want to hear, to be honest, because it's something I've always been asked about. I always talk about the frequency, the volume. But actually, how much volume should you be doing? How many sets per exercise, per body part, per workout should you be doing? And I'm going to go into that today to kind of just get it out there and give you guys some actual numbers to go off rather than just say start with low volume and work up, which is what I've kind of been saying. But I can kind of give you examples of where you should be starting in terms of volume and where you should be going in terms of volume. So we're going to do that. The first things first is breakfast. Breakfast is usually the same. This is not gonna work. Breakfast is usually the same. One bagel, 30 grams of jam, and a protein shake. So it got to the point for me where food was like really. I'm not gonna be in that. It got to the point for me where food was really difficult to eat, so I needed a meal plan just to help me with digestion, to help me with food choices, all that kind of stuff, because I was just eating the same foods and it was killing me. So my coach actually makes me he makes me a food plan, which is absolutely fine. All I do is I eat that pretty much 95% of the time, and then like the other 5% I'll swap out like for like, carbohydrate to carbohydrate. So, and that's something that you guys should take into consideration is flexibility. If you're being told to do one thing and one thing only, like there's definitely another way to do it. So if you're not enjoying it, you can swap, obviously. So don't get too caught up in it. This is the first time that he's jumped up on here. We used to have a sofa that came just a little bit lower. This one's a little bit higher because he's got three legs. He struggles to get up. Making him gains. All right, then, guys, it's time for my second favorite part of the day. It's intra workout time. Why is it my second favorite time? Because it's the time before I train. Let's fucking do this. Okay. We talk about how many sets you should be doing. I'm going to show you my push workout with my boy Jake Maddox, who is one of my clients. Maybe I'll do a physique update for you guys. I haven't done that in a while. So I'm going to take you through this. Let's get it. So we are warming up. We're getting everything firing to start off with. I'm trying to build my collarbones. And if you are anyone out there, you're probably trying to build your collarbones up too. Upper chest is much, much harder to fill out the upper chest versus the lower chest. So doing these kind of movements, focus on coming down, bringing the elbows down, bringing the elbows towards and squeezing up here. That's where you're really gonna feel those clavicle fibers move. So give this one a go if you haven't, and focus on the upper chest. We're moving on to a reverse banded incline Smith machine press. So this basically just helps the strength profile of the pec. And we know as we come back down, kind of tension on the pec will reduce a little bit more into the shoulders. So it just helps me out that girdle and then puts all the pressure onto the chest, focusing on bringing elbows through. You can go pretty heavy on this because of the reverse band too.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. cast screaming, oh my god, he's back. Just imagine, hit the lab and get it cracking. A thousand styles and one verse rhythm to switch patterns. Chicks get stabbed in the back till they get stabbed. Known as spit a magnum or spit a hatter. Who would've known that Jesus would come back to the ghetto on that level and that feral like a black arrow with packed metal. So rap rebels and black pedal the feral with five pedals to take over the rap level. Getting bizarre, this is for y'all, cripple and fall.
Okay then, guys, that was absolutely lovely jubbly. I'm gonna put a little video over the top of this. This is my current physique, guys. I'm very happy with how I'm looking at 101.8 kilos this morning. That's the heaviest I've been all off season. And probably the best I've looked at this weight ever. I've been slightly higher, but never have I looked this good. I feel leaner than ever, bigger than ever, fuller than ever. I feel good. So I'm very happy with where I am. Still lots to push up before like a pull back, resensitize, get a little bit leaner, so I'm in a good position to prep. And that'd be it, guys. I've got like 6 months, 7 months left of this strong off season. And then we Gucci. Let's talk about the title of the video. How many sets should you be doing on each body part? So I'm gonna break it down for you. I'm gonna make it easy for you. Bigger body parts, for example, back, legs, and chest are probably gonna need slightly higher volume. Now, I'm gonna set you a maximum set of 20 sets per week. Most likely, it's gonna be your back and it's gonna be your legs that are gonna be getting 20 sets, and then everything else. So what I want you to start off with, first of all, you're going to be hitting everything twice a week. So you should be doing a push-pull legs repeat, or you should be doing some training plan in capacity that you're hitting everything twice a week. And bearing in mind that you're hitting everything twice a week, you want to split this volume. So I'm going to give you a maximum of 6 sets to do on your chest in each session. 6 sets, 3 exercises, 2 top sets on each. For your back, I'm going to be giving you 8 sets per session on your body pack. So that's 8 sets in the first session. That's 8 sets in the second session. For your delts, and we're talking every single delt here, I want you to hit at least 6 sets per session. That means maybe 2 on the lateral, 2 on the rear. Maybe that means 3 on the lateral, 3 on the rear. Don't worry about your front delts because you're going to be pressing a lot. For your legs, I want a minimum of 6 sets per quads and a minimum of 5 sets on your hamstrings. Or you can flip those around if you've got stronger quads, do less sets, and I want you to do more sets on hamstrings. As we move into delts and arms, again, I want these to be very, very similar. 3 sets on your biceps each time you do it, 3 sets on your triceps each time you do it, that's 12 sets over the week. So let's run down from the top to the bottom. Shoulders, I want you to do a minimum of 12 sets per week. Chest, I want you to do a minimum of 12 sets per week. Arms, a minimum of 10 sets per week. Legs, quads and hams, I want you to be doing a minimum of 12 sets, 10 to 12 sets on your quads and 10 to 12 sets on your hamstrings. And for your back, a minimum of about 16 sets per week. So your back's gonna take the most, legs the second most, and then the rest of it. Why? Because it's not too high whatsoever. That's very much on the low side. And bearing in mind, guys, what you wanna bring up, you would pull down the sets on the other. So if your back's very, very strong, you wouldn't do 16 sets, you'd probably pull that down to 12 sets, and you'd push your chest up a little bit to 16 sets, for example. But if everything's pretty even, that's probably the best way to go. Start with like a minimum of 4, 5, 6 sets on each body part. And from there, what I want you to do is monitor your recovery, your progress,
And generally your overall feeling. If you feel like you're progressing well, training well, recovering very, very well, I want you to push one extra set onto all of those. So that means you'll be doing 13 sets on your chest, 17 sets on your back, and you get my drift. If all of those three markers hit the same things again, I want you to increase it again. And now this might be that your back doesn't recover, but your chest does, so you push more on the chest. This might mean that your nothing recovers, so you stay the same, and you try and increase the strength every single time. But those are some very, very good numbers to go off. If you're doing less than those, then put them up to that. If you're doing way, way more than those, take them back down to what I've said, and increase your intensity. Get to maximum muscular failure. I'm talking about you're doing this for a press, and you're coming back down for a press until you physically can't. No more of this bullshit half reps, fast reps, anything like that. Muscular failure. Put the muscle through the pain, not the body. And I promise you, you're going to get something out of it. I hope that made sense to you guys. I'm going to head back. That pre-workout fucked me up a little bit. I feel a little bit spacey. So guys, that's literally how I want to end the video, is just by explaining how many sort of sets you should be doing. So I've given you a range, I've given you a minimum range to go off, and this will apply for women as well. The only thing I will say is that girls can tend to push themselves a little bit harder. They've got better recovery capabilities just because of the estrogen to testosterone balance. We know that estrogen helps with recovery a lot. So I tend to give girls slightly more, and so if you are a girl, maybe add a one or two sets onto that, and just go from there and take it as it comes, guys. Prioritize what you want to grow first in terms of frequency, balance that volume over the week, and hit those sets that we've talked about. I hope this guy's gave you some clarity as to what sort of sets you should be aiming for, what sort of sets I'm aiming for, what sort of sets a lot of these like low volume, high intensity guys are going for now, and just to be productive in terms of recovery as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll be back very, very soon with a full day of eating video. Thank you guys, appreciate it.
Appreciate it, mate.